Greetings, world. We are anonymous. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us. We as citizens wonder why the justice system in Canada fails. We wonder why mental health is at an all-time high. We wonder why nothing is done about these until you actually look at the laws. The Criminal Code is a law that codifies most criminal offenses and procedures in Canada. Its official long title is An Act Respecting the Criminal Law RSC 1985. The Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms forms the first part of the Constitution Act 1982. Alberta Human Rights Act Revised 2000. Mental Health Act 2000. These laws have not been changed in years. Today is far more advanced than back then, and our laws should be revised at least every 5 years because our society now is completely different than it was 15 to 30 years ago. Murders and rapists get off with a slap on the wrist because it is all based on our old legal system laws. If they were actually revised recently, then maybe the crime rate would be down. And these people would be locked away for good instead of getting back out and reoffending again. We cannot change the world for the better until our justice system revises the laws to fit the current society that we now live in. In order to help with mental health, we should be doing mental testing every time someone renews their driver's licenses or passports, whichever comes first. This way no one can slip through the system by faking tests and making them sound like they don't have a mental issue, because a simple test can be faked by someone with a mental illness. And people with this illness don't think they have a problem. So making it mandatory can weed out and help individuals struggling with certain illness. We shouldn't have to waste our tax dollars on people that have petty charges locked away because of 1985 laws. Instead, we should revise them to suit today's society so the proper justice can go to those that deserve it. As of 2018, the drunk driving laws have changed. But they still are not harsh. Immediate 90-day license suspension for impaired drivers, followed by participation in a one-year ignition interlock program. This means that after 90 days the driver can be out doing it again and possibly killing someone because he thinks he got away with it the first time. It is not hard to get a sober person to blow into a box for you in your car to make it look like you are not driving drunk. Our Canadian laws are a joke. Then everyone wonders why nothing is working or why there isn't harsher penalties. It is because we need to make our laws more strict. We are anonymous. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.